Hey, what is up, everybody? Happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. I did this commentary yesterday, so I didn't mention anything about it being Father's Day, but I want to give a quick shout out to all of you out there. I hope y'all are having a great day, and I hope you enjoy the video. Peace out. Hey, what is up, everybody? It's Truce Chaos here, and today I'm bringing you guys some Call of Duty Black Ops 3 gameplay. And today we have the Banshee in the background, and I'll get a little bit more into the Banshee here in a moment. But, so I'm trying a new way of recording commentary, and I'm using actually Audacity, which is what I use whenever I do the live commentaries that I've done in the past, because I need to upgrade my editing software, excuse me. Because recently my computer made us upgrade to Windows 10, and out of nowhere, like, it kept telling us to upgrade to Windows 10, and we were like, no, screw that. We always hear people have problems with that, right? So we were like, no, we don't want Windows 10, but it made us upgrade to Windows 10. Like, one day, like, it just shut our computer down, upgraded us to Windows 10, and that was it. There was no choice in the matter. So let me know down in the comments if that has happened to any of you all, because it seems to have tampered with some of my stuff. Like, my editing software doesn't work right anymore. I need to upgrade it. It keeps popping up a little upgrade thing, you know, every now and then whenever I use it. So I do know I need to upgrade it. And maybe it's just one of the things, like, all right, I've held off too long on upgrading my editing software. So I don't know, but hopefully this works out pretty good. And yeah. So anyways, the Banshee. How did I come across getting the Banshee? Well, I now have every DLC weapon except for the Rift E9. Before this group of DLC weapons came out, the Banshee, Buzzcut, Nightbreaker, and Rift E9, I did have every DLC weapon. So how I ended up coming across the Banshee is when I completed the 75 win contract, I saved my weapon bribe. And I was like, well, there's no point in using it since I have every DLC weapon. So I saved it because I knew they were eventually going to bring out more DLC weapons. And I'm sure we'll see more after these. So I saved that, and I saved all my crypto keys and everything. And when they released these new weapons, I used my crypto keys and I ended up getting the buzz cut. And like the second drop I opened, I got the Nightbreaker more towards the end of the crypto keys and all that. And then with the weapon bribe, I got the Banshee. So I was pretty happy. And I'd say with the luck I have in supply drops, I will end up probably seeing the Rift E9 at some point. Maybe in the near future, who knows. But the Banshee, I have to say, it is a ton of fun to use. It is really, really fun to use this gun, especially once you start getting accustomed to it. Now, with that being said, this is not an easy gun to just pick up and play well with. This is the best gameplay I've got with it, and it's just a... I would say it's maybe slightly above average gameplay probably with this gun, but this is definitely not one of my better gameplays. I mean, I think I did pretty well given using this gun. This was probably like the third time I've used it. This is the first time I've used it in a full match and didn't end up switching classes to a different class setup, so there is that. But with the Banshee, the biggest thing about it is, you know, I'm sure you guys know by now that you have to lead your target, right? Because the energy burst travels fairly slowly. I mean, it travels faster than what I initially thought it did whenever I first used it, especially after getting more accustomed to using the gun. But you still have to lead your target, so that can be a bit difficult. And the way you have to play with this gun is very methodically. You know, you don't want to play too passively, but you don't want to play too aggressive. So you kind of have to find a median there. And it also might depend on who you are as a player. You know, is your snap aim good? Is your accuracy good? You know, you got to really be careful about how you flow around a map. Because I'd say you can't play with this gun like you're playing with the Haymaker, Breccia, or the KRM. But you can't play with it like you're playing with an assault rifle or an LMG either. You kind of have to find that median there. So it's definitely not overpowered. No DLC weapon is overpowered, and I'll talk about that in a different video if you guys would like, because I definitely have a very solid foot in that argument, considering I've used every DLC weapon except for most of the melees, because the melees are pretty much all the same, just reskinned versions of one another, and the Rift D9. So there is no DLC weapon that's overpowered. Not the HG40, not the FFAR, not the Banshii, not the Marshals, maybe a little bit, but I mean, you know, they act just like a shotgun, and it's a shotgun pistol. So, and I still don't think the Marshals were ever overpowered. And I can go into detail on all that stuff in a different video if you guys would like. But yeah, man, so let me know. Did you get lucky enough to get the Banshii, the Rift D9? Do you have any DLC weapons? What DLC weapons do you have? Let me know down in the comments, man. Anyways, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I'll definitely have some more Banshii gameplays, given I can get better gameplays than this with it. But yeah, this gun is a ton of fun to use, man. So if you're trying to get it, keep trying. I hope you get it. Anyways, I hope y'all have a great, safe, and wonderful day. And I will see you on the next video. Peace out.